But also, I think it's the religious thing, you know, like that's what we come across with what we offer. You know, people say, you know, because it's Hinduism or it's religious, or it seems like that people are a little bit cautious to some people cautious to get into it because they feel like, oh, I'm not a Hindu, or I don't want to, it's religion. And we always say, like, these mantras, they are way before any concept of religion. It's an
exactly
language, you know. And
no, it's exactly right. They're independent of religion. They date before religion really arose, before there was a need really for religion, because it was a time in which people simply understood the vibrational nature of, you know, the world. And this is a place where I feel science is of so much help, because when we do look at just scientific studies, because we would typically look at science as devoid of religious bias, you see in the studies that these mantras, despite their origin, whether they're Tibetan mantras, whether they're Sanskrit mantras, whether, you know, no matter whether they're Gregorian chants, that they're doing something on a physiological level, and on a psychological level. So independent of the fact that religions eventually did incorporate mantra and sound into their practice, they work independent of any type of religious organization. Mm. They're working on a very, very fundamental level it's really on a level of quantum physics. It's on a very, very subtle vibrational level.
Mm. And very, very specific scientific level also. It's
very specific, yes. Yeah. And that's what's amazing to me.